Hello and welcome back, friends. Today we're going to be talking about Jujutsu Kaisen Curse Clash. As I have told you guys before, this is a gaming slash anime channel, and it's going to be the first anime game that I cover on the channel. So I thought, you know what, how about we talk about it a little bit before the game comes out. The game is coming out February 1st, for those of you who don't know, and it is available for pre-order with pre-order bonuses and all that good stuff. So far, what we know from the game, it is from the same creators of My Hero Academia, One's Justice 1 and 2. The combat is fairly similar. You have your regular attacks, your heavy attacks, and your grabs. Grabs, I believe, are red. Unblockables are yellow. And then your regular attacks are not highlighted in any color. What makes this different from My Hero Academia is that it's actually a tag team battle system. And you have regular attacks, and then people have cursed techniques. Your regular attacks actually won't be doing any damage to the player, to the enemy player. If you want to do health damage, some significant damage, you have to use your curse technique. What's interesting about this is that in the Jujutsu Kaisen anime, every single character's curse technique is extremely unique. There isn't one that's similar, which we're going to be discussing in today's video. And it seems like from the gameplay, the producers are really trying to achieve that same uniqueness that you get in the anime. Today, we're going to be discussing every character that has been shown to the public in the trailers. One thing I would like to talk about before getting to the characters of the game is the mode. It seems like we have, you know, your standard player versus player, player versus PC, but we also have a PvE mode. Now, I don't know if you guys know this, but in the earlier Naruto games and Demon Slayer game as well, you would fight different kind of enemies. Enemies that were not characters, larger enemies that had special attacks. They were kind of like boss enemies. In Demon Slayer on the PS5 and PC, Xbox X, all that good stuff, you can really see them pushing the story elements a bit more and being just a little bit more than an arena fighter. And it seems like this time around, Jujutsu Kaisen Curse Clash wants to do the same thing. You're going to be able to level up your character kind of like in an RPG. I don't know how in-depth these mechanics are going to be, but they're still going to be there, allowing for some customization. Not only that, you'll be fighting curses, and these curses are not going to be character models. They're going to be actual monsters. How in-depth these curses and monsters are going to be, I don't really know. How many levels are there going to be? Again, that is yet to be found out. But I'm looking forward to seeing what they're going to do with this, because I'm honestly tired of arena fighters. Honestly, I love anime games, and I would love to play an anime game with the same amount of polish as Demon Slayer, Naruto Ninja Storm, but make it an action adventure game, or make it a RPG. Why are we stuck with these arena fighters? Let me play as Tanjiro. Let me play his story. Give me a story mode where I get to play as Tanjiro and I get to fight a bunch of demons. Please, make it happen. Make it happen, CyberConnect. Now, jumping into the characters. First on our list is Yuji Itadori, the protagonist himself, Mr. Left, Right, Good Night. As some of you may or may not know, Yuji actually doesn't have a curse technique, but has tremendous physical strength and has his own special technique called Divergent Fist. You see, his punches were so fast that the curse energy buildup couldn't keep up with his speed, so he would attack the opponent and then there would be a small lag until the curse energy would reach, creating a lag effect on the opponent. He's also quite adept at Black Flash, which shouldn't be a thing. The sparks of black does not choose sides. It is simply blesses a sorcerer who's ever in the zone. Basically, Black Flash is a 1.2 times multiplier, 1.5 times multiplier, I can't exactly remember. And after learning about the Black Flash for the first time, Yuji consecutively pulls off 4 back-to-back. Quick disclaimer, we are going to only be talking about Season 1 and... Yeah, we're only going to be talking about Season 1 anime, since the game seems to only be covering Season 1. Who are you most excited to see in Jujutsu Kaisen Curse Clash? Let me know in the comment section below. Next, we have the Sasuke ripoff himself, Megumi Fushiguro, who has the 10 Shadows technique, which allows him to summon up to 10 Shikigamis in the game. However, I think he's only going to have access to 3 of them. He's going to have the Frog, the Divine Dog, and Nue, from what I've seen in the in in the trailer. He also has a domain expansion. However, it is an incomplete domain, so he can't just cast the domain in an empty area. He needs to be in an enclosed space for him to use his domain. There is no sure hit effect because it is incomplete, but it seems like he can just use all of his Shikigami all willy-nilly as much as he likes, whenever, however he likes. In the game, it seems like this is going to be represented as a huge chunk of damage to whoever is being caught in the domain expansion. After that, we have the badass Nobara. She is going to be a long-range character. Her curse technique is the straw doll technique, where she, if she has like a piece of a person, like maybe hair or a finger or an arm, she can put a nail in the piece, in the arm, and if she strikes it with her hammer, her cursed tool, it's going to create resonance and it's going to inflict damage to that person. There is a certain distance to how far the person can be, but it's a pretty significant amount of damage depending on what she's striking. If it's hair, it's not that bad, but if it's like a whole arm or something of that nature, she can do quite a bit of damage from quite a bit of distance. Next is our boy Satoru freaking Gojo. He is the sensei of the group. He is the wielder of the six eyes and the limitless technique, which allows him to control the space of infinity. Basically, he has this like protective aura around him that doesn't actually stop things. It simply slows them down. You know how it's like if something is 10 feet away and you get halfway there every time you take a step forward, how much time does it take for you to get there? And the answer is you would never get there because you're always moving halfway closer. Basically, that is his curse technique. In the game, he's going to have his curse technique blue and red. Blue attracts things, red repulses things, and it seems like he's also going to have his ability hollow purple. All of these abilities take a lot of time to charge up, but they all do tons of damage. He's also going to have access to his domain expansion, Infinite Void, which basically floods a person's mind with infinite information, rendering them completely incapacitated, allowing Gojo to just do whatever he wants with them, mostly murder. Can I say that? Seems like in the game, he's also going to be able to have some type of shield around him. This makes him invulnerable to damage for a set period of time. Ryomen Sukuna is in the game. Fun fact about Ryomen Sukuna, all of his attacks damage his allies as well. Yes, this is the kind of player you're going to be playing with if you're playing Ryomen Sukuna. His attacks do friendly fire. This is his gimmick. This is how they make him different. We still don't know what his curse technique is called. However, we do know what his domain expansion is. It's called Malevolent Shrine. We haven't seen any gameplay on it yet. What I think the way it's going to function is that whoever gets caught in the domain, everyone just takes a huge bam chunk of damage, kind of like Megumi's ability, but a full domain instead of a domain where you can fight in, kind of like Mahito and Jogo. Next up is my personal best girl. We have Maki Zenin. She has heavenly restriction on her, which means she has no curse technique, but she does have curse tool. She's all about using crazy weapons to take down her opponents. She is best girl. I don't care what you guys have to say. I will fight you on this. I'm really looking forward to see how Maki is going to play in the PvE. I think she's going to be a quick and agile character and a lot of fun to play. Next up is Jogo, a cursed spirit of fire or volcanoes, something of that matter. He is a special grade, which is the most important thing. From what I understand, he is going to be a quick mid-range fighter, kind of like a rogue type, and he's also going to be able to set up traps. He strictly uses fire and also has a domain expansion. His domain expansion is called Coffin of the Iron Mountain, which basically just eliminates people who are inside because it's so hot. I could see them use this in the game, so like anyone who's stuck in Jogo's domain simply takes damage over time. I'm really looking forward to seeing how they implement this in the game. Then we have Hanami. Hanami is also a curse technique of special grade proportion. It's in like the curse technique of the forest or something like that. From what I saw in the anime and looking at the game, Hanami is probably going to be like your mid-range tank, going to be very good at setting up plays for the attack types to come in and do the killing blow. I don't think Hanami is going to be dealing out a bunch of damage. It's mostly about setting up plays for your teammates, which honestly for a tag team game is great. I love to see characters have more roles than just, you know, damage. Last special red curse on our list is going to be Mahito, the curse of humans himself. This guy is insane. His curse technique is called Idol Transfiguration, where he can manipulate the soul. In the game, he seems like he's a mid to close range fighter. He can like stretch out his limbs. It's really weird and stuff. He's got a couple of techniques like soul manipulability, body repel, polymorphic soul isomer, which he like creates a stand or something like that. It seems like from what I saw in the gameplay, Mahito can actually, he can have summons with him on the field. I did not see what his curse, his domain does. His domain, by the way, is called Self-Embodiment of Perfection, which allows him to instantly transfigure anyone's soul in his domain without actually touching them, because you know that guaranteed sure hit. So being in Mahito's domain is basically instant KO. Fun thing about Mahito, Mahito's regular combo string at the very end of it does damage to your opponent, even though it's not a curse technique, probably reflecting the fact that he's doing damage to the person's soul. Kento Nanami, Big Daddy himself, is in this game, and boy oh boy, I gotta say I'm excited. He is the wielder of a blunt weapon curse technique, curse tool, and he's also the wielder of the curse technique ratio. Basically, what Nanami's curse technique does is that it creates a line on his target, and he creates 10 little lines, and if he hits that number 3 or that number 7, it does critical damage. So even though he's fighting someone stronger than him, he can still do that crit, baby. And the way they're gonna be representing that in the game is that when you attack an enemy, you're gonna have like a little ratio mini game up here, and you're gonna have to hit that button again at the correct time to do that critical damage and have that sick JoJo pose at the end of it. He also has his binding vow overtime, where basically Nanami hates doing overtime work. If ever he's doing jujutsu work past 515, I believe, he can now use 120% of his curse energy, because throughout the entire day, he's only running at 80%. So once he gets into overtime, he's actually going to be using 120%. The way that they're going to be reflecting this in the game is that when there's 1 minute left in the game, Nanami's curse technique, his curse gauge actually, is going to refill insanely fast. And last but not least, we have Kechizu and Echizu, the death paintings. These two brothers will be playing as one character. They have this rot technique that has to do with their blood. Like when it gets on you, it infects you, and then he can activate his maximum technique, Decay, which does damage over time, ultimately, you know, just killing you. This will be represented in the game as well. I believe like every time you hit an opponent with one of your curse techniques, whether it's Kechizu's or Ichizu's ability, it is going to apply one mark of decay, and then at some point you can activate it doing a whole lot of damage. I can't remember if it's by doing, I think the more blood you get on the person, the more damage you get. I think you can stack three stacks of decay before actually doing a bunch of damage. All right, and that's it for all of the characters we know that's coming out in Jujutsu Kaisen Curse Clash. I am super excited for the game. I know that the hidden inventory is going to be a DLC, so there'll be more characters then. If you guys are interested in Jujutsu Kaisen Curse Clash, let me know in the comment section below. Let me know if this is something you guys want me to talk about more often. I can do an in-depth breakdown of the characters. That'd be a lot of fun, actually. If you want continuous updates on anime gaming, and maybe even possibly anime content, be sure to subscribe so you know when I'm posting another video, so you can stay updated and all that good stuff. I hope this video helped you out, and if it didn't, well, remember, at the end of the day, I'm just some guy on the internet, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace. Yo, thank you for making it to the end of the video. Holy shit, that was 26 minutes?